they are not happy with the situation of the transporter in Nigeria. They have what we call the Kakaros bill. For instance, I came from Kano, 4,000. Suddenly, I get to Kano. That's 5,000. Assuming I don't have extra money, that means I will be stranded. And I've been challenging them what they are doing is wrong. No increment is fair. The road is good. What's the point of increasing transportation? Well, you know the situation of Nigeria now. The transporters should be very, very careful because they are the cause of our problem. They have to change their attitude. If there is fuel problem now, we will say it's government problem. But there's no increment is fair. They will just sit down, collect money from passengers, and decide on their own anyhow. We are having serious burden on us. So my own suggestion is that they should talk to the transporter to change their system. Because once we increase any transport fare, it will affect all other things.
Everybody knows the country is now. So everybody knows that the country is big. There's no money. People no travel. This is salary. We know we increase our price. The same amount that we have been carrying. It's also we are carrying also now. We are selling.
Okay, how much is it?
We are carrying 8,000, 7,000 naira. Actually now the same thing. From here to Lagos, we even give our open to hands. That is why. And if we say we solve, we have another opportunity, or we have another thing to do. We leave the team. We cannot risk our life. So we still begging our government that they put more effort in the term of the security. For us, because we are taking this risk, no,
it's not small.
With what you are seeing in the park now, people are not traveling as expected because people are afraid because of the security. Then the prices of the motor fares have increased. So people are finding it difficult. So instead of traveling, they don't prefer to just use the money and just take care of whatever they want to. Maybe send money to whoever they want to come visit and then do the celebration between life is everybody takes risk. We are always taking risks. So if you see people traveling, they just believe that life is one. So, and there is no any other way than to take risks. Even self, nothing is worth risking for. But you just have to just take risk. For every day of our life is risk. Even in your house, you are at risk. But what I will suggest is that people should reduce the rumors because fake news all over the place are even making people to even panic more. Before you even see the real thing, you will end up panicking and you might result to another health issue.
If I have a trip to travel, if I sit in one place, definitely I cannot survive because I need the money to survive. So I just pray to my God to help me so that they know to be safe for me to travel. But if I travel like I'm traveling on my own without any money, I won't try to travel. There's no need for that. But when you offer me money, I'm doing this for the money, I'm doing the trip.
If you enter the other side, you know what
has been me. The road is happening. You see what is happening. Attacking our senators and house of
where one going?
Talking about ordinary people. The senator will come and complain that his way coming from the go to Kuki. They attacked all the escorts around him. So what do you think will happen to ordinary people that don't have escorts? So nobody is saving this country. This security is smart. So everybody is afraid to travel. Look at those that have the little money to travel. They are afraid. It's only God that will save us. But for a human being, I don't think we can. The insecurity in this country now. Is above human beings. Our president is not saying anything. He has not addressed it. We only hear from the presidency. President. We didn't vote the presidency, we vote the president. But the president refused to address the nation.